Good morning, Dave Greaves. Other members of the PhD. And I want to thank viewers and social media good morning. Beginning this morning service, we're on page 17 in the store and page 12 in the night. Basima, Babo, Basido, Zahuana, Amen. Oh my God, take your blessings and ask forgiveness. So then we obtain mercy before going out of the church, where the pure sacrifice of our will be half on time. Do not separate thyself for the peace of things, and offer the sacrifice of thy every day, in order to make a call of the baptized and sent out, but abide within the church, and listen to the word of Christ, and listen to him who hath forgiven us on behalf of thee. And all sinners, that the God may grant pardon to them. O man, if thou desire to see forgiveness of thy sin, why dost thou from the church, while the foreigner shall have mercy on thy behalf, and while thou hast another time, you let your mind wander from place to place, you must see the receipt of a heavenly Bible, even Christ. For the church will dismiss thee and shut the door against thee, so thou wilt never enter, because no stranger will be found in her. When the bridegroom cometh, she shall open to him her doors, and his bride fear the bridegroom. But the stranger shall not be, because it is not given to him. Who, until the bridegroom at the marriage, shall be guided his body and tread on forever. The Son of God and the good people, which no one except him had done, like him to the creation of the world. As his marriage, he had ordained all the things before his guest, his holy body and his precious blood of banquet, so that they may go. And so that we believe him and live forever, the meat and drink of our Lord Jesus Christus, as his marriage, blessed be our God. Was given his holy body and precious blood for the forgiveness of sins, that we may live thereby forever. Glory be to him, world without end. Amen. We continue in one civil to pray for Holy Mary, the mother of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christus. A hymn of praise for Sabbath of Christian Day, Sunday. You are named, beloved of blessed among women. You are the second chamber, for you walk all holy of holies, where the tables of a covenant continue kept words, which were written by the fingers of God as he kept. This he had made known to us first by letter after, but it is the first letter of the name of the King of Jesus Christus, who became incarnate from without change. He became the mediator of the new covenant, and by the shedding of his blood, he purified the people and the holy people, waiting for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for
us. We are glorified, O Holy Lamb of God. Lift up your eyes to the moon, we invoke you. Pray for us that we find grace, by grace, and mercy to you, the love of man. You are the temple of God, which is covered over the world, which have been made of good. The never perish, signifying for the good of the month of separation and change. Even the holy but not fair name is co-equal with the Father, was announced to us in the world. Without sin, became like unto us, the might of his wisdom. He who was incarnate from him, even he who was spotless, members of the Trinity with us, waiting for us, the Holy One. And become the victim of our sins, and preserve our transgressions. We give us the Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are the Lord of the Lord of the Lord. Where is the head of the man and the protected of the one? We give life to all the world. We give us the Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
which is the light of the world, life of the Lord, beginning, verily God, from verily God, from the creation, without change, and by his coming, he shed light upon us, upon the roads of us who sit in shadow and darkness of death. He set our feet upon the path of peace, for the mission of holy wisdom, with the pass of holy one.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
And so we call you calico of the blessed fire, which he took from the sanctuary. He knew the word of God, making a creature of you, and you offer up his father and seven incense and precious offerings. We give first a holy one.
Oh, Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
Father, God, Mother, Light, God, my joy, which is planted with trees of Lebanon, I want to prepare for the city, for the world was created, for the grave carrier, which are guided by the children, and the seraphim, for the first of all, the flame of fire, one of the seraphim, the winter of heaven, and said to her in sanctuary, blessed are the Lord among women, and the Holy Spirit shall come unto thee, and the power of the high shall overshadow thee, for he who put up our children shall become the light of all the world. Rejoice, O Mary, fruitful dove, you are born for us, the Word of God, and you are the sweet spirit of love, with us from the root of Jesse. With him for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are like God, the Word of the Lord, and being planted in the ground, and with the water and mercy to blossom. In like manner, you, O bear of Christ, the faithful Christ was born in truth without sin. He came by the name of us. With him for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
It is need for you, O Lord, for the great one of all the saints to pray for me. You are greater than the high priest, and you are more honorable than the prophets. In you, there is a modesty of appearance, which is greater than the modesty of a seraphim and the cherubim. Verily, you are glory for grace, and you must obey for life for our soul. We love the Lord, the Lord and Giver, Jesus Christus, that he may come from us in the right way, that we see faith in him, and that he may graciously bestow mercy and compassion, and may the world bear mercy and forgive our sins forever and ever. Amen. We give us, O Holy One.
As we continue our service as a priest chants for your meditation, Psalm 75. Tessa,
King, your Yeah.
Glory.
but on a greater painting. The one invisible, pure and holy, and yet hands out to us of thy visible and glory. Thou hast made us open and quenchable light, and we keep thy servants open to thee. Glory, thanksgiving, and holiness, and the people glorify.
O Lord, glorify thee. O God of light, who are the source of light, the head of knowledge, give our praise for the perfect grace. Make of the soul, give of God, give of the Holy Spirit, the treasure of wisdom, the helper, the teacher of the sin, the foundation of the world. Who accepted the prayer of the Holy Ones, we glorify the only begotten Son, the firstborn of the Father, thou hast granted universal grace to us who call upon thee. O pure and blameless Father, thou hast a treasure that mortal trust do not corrupt, and of which thou givest to those who trust upon thee in all their thoughts. Thou didst make the angels desire the light which was before the world, and thou art our changeable guardian. To thy Father's pleasure thou hast enlightened us. We who are treasure of darkness, we who thou hast brought from darkness to light, and granted us life after death, and granted us freedom from slavery. With thy cross thou hast brought us nearer to thy Father in heaven. With the gospel thou hast led us, with the prophets thou hast comforted us. We who thou hast brought nigh, O God, give us, O God, life. We praise thee, O God, at with ceaseless thanksgiving. We may say that we are thy servants, and the people praise thee.
O Lord, we praise thee. O Jesus, the Son of God, who art above all, thrice do we offer thanksgiving unto thee with thy Father and thy eternal kingdom. And all the creatures glorify thee in trembling and fear of soul. Every soul fears thee, and all the souls of the righteous trust in thee. Thou who didst quiet the stormy floods of the evil spirits for us, and who became to us life of destruction, and a refuge where there is hope of eternal salvation. Thou savest those who are troubled on the sea. To thy grace thou healest those who are in the wilderness. Thou accompanest those who imprisonment is very hard. So loosen us from the bond of death. Thou comfortest the miserable with weeping. Thou savest the weak with thy cross. Thou takest away and removest all the wrath from us who have trusted in thee. O Lord, whom the prophets of the apostle time secretly we thank thee. We glorify thee so that believing in thee and fulfill thy will may rest in the abode of life. Grant us to walk according to thy order, O Lord. To thy mercy visit all, small and great, rulers and people, shepherd and flock. For thine is the kingdom, blessed Lord our God. Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit before the creation of the world, both now and ever, from generation to endless generation, and world without end.
Amen.
We shall not sing the Lord's Prayer, chit song.
Abba, Tate, O Ye,
the last Of my enemies.
Thou anointest my head, oh, and my cup
runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life,
and I shall dwell
in the house of the Lord forever.
Rise, O God, unto me, O Lord, let us go to the wedding when they call in the gate of Galilee, and let us bless for them the water and change it into wine. Do thou a night sort unto this wine which is set before thee. Now also let me bless our Lord and pure, that our name may become the life of soul and body and spirit at all times. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with us, and fill the wine with joy and happiness for goodness, for life, for salvation, and for remission of sin, for understanding, for healing, for the counsel of the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and world without end. Sweetness and blessing be to them that truly drink of thy precious blood. O King Xavier, Abba, Sinkolo, Aleba, Blagenda. Ego, Guero, and Sin, Jesus Christus, Peranina. Ego, Man, Pesquitus, Paraclitus, Pesdeo, Pansego, Lenda.
And accept thy sacrifice and offering, like the sacrifice of Melchizedek and Aaron and Zacharias, the priests of the church of the firstborn, Abatachinhoi, Besimai, Metno, Semekades, Mengistitimta, Fekadi, Besimai, the own each in the whom Bemidel tune, Yelet interlatching in Satan Azaria, Bedelachin, Yakabalin. In ya ye bedelun in ye crendem nella beitu with a fadana matagvan, keke fuluad den inje, menges yantanatina, haile miskanam, lazile ale muamen, ime beta chinke des dingel mariam hoi, ime malaku picadus Gabriel, salam ta salam in leshalen, basabish dingel nish, visgashim dingel nish, yoshana fixia belinat hoi, salam ta lanchie gabashal. Kesia tush hulu tiliati shanchi tabare kishnish, yamai simnish felditabare kino, sagan itimilashoi, Esiebeli, Shigziabi el Kanchikaranuna, Ketu Widlejish, Kigita Chin, Kibanan Tachin, Jesus Christus en Yukultan Leminilin, Hatia Tachin, Yasis Relins en Lesileale Muamin. Be pleased, Lord, to save me. Be pleased, Lord, to save me. Be pleased, Lord, to save me.
Oh. God is thine, and receive us unto himself, and unto thee, now repent, and drink us and brought us unto the soul. Let us therefore pray that your mighty Lord, O God, keep us in this holy day and all the days of our life and all the week. Praise the Lord God Almighty, the Father of our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ. We render thee thanks upon everything, for everything and everything. For thou hast covered us and succored us and kept us and brought us nigh. And receive us unto thyself and unto thee, now repent and strengthen us and brought us unto the soul.
Yes, Lord, wash that me
Oh.
For the deity and the faithful, which is God, we pray. Thank you.
Amen. Glory be to the Father, glory be to the Son, glory be to the Holy Spirit. Glory be to the Father, glory be to the Son, glory be to the Holy Spirit. Glory be to the Father, glory be to the Son, glory be to the Holy
Spirit.
Amen. Apostle Paul, good messenger, heal of the sick, who have received the crown, ask and pray for us in order that he may save our soul in the multitude of his mercy and his pity for his holy name's sake. Slaman Vesaka.
The second lesson is taken from Revelation 21 from 1 to 8. The word of the revelation of John, disciple and apostle of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, his prayers and blessings be with all holy Trinity, Abuna Marcos and Abuna Matthias, and our blessed Archbishop Abbatadius, and our clergy and congregation forever.
Amen.
Second lesson is taken from Revelation chapter 21 from verse 1 to 8. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God, out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the fearful and unbelieving and abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Amen.
Amen.
O my brethren, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For the world passeth away, and the lust thereof, for all is passing.
Holy consubstantial Trinity, preserve our congregation for thy holy act disciples' sake. Comfort us in thy mercy for thy holy name's sake. Slaman Feseke.
The pure foundation, the pure fountain of the Lord, the visitation of the hands of the apostles, the blessed of the prayer, the gift of the patriarchs, of the prios, of the Matthias, and the blessed Archbishop of Matthias, and the clergy of the congregation forever.
Amen.
The lesson is taken from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 21. From verse 31 to the end. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 21, from verse 31 to the end. And as they went about to kill him, tidings came on to the chief captain of the band, that all Jerusalem was in an uproar, who immediately took soldiers and centurions and ran down unto them. And when they saw the chief captain and the soldiers, they left beating of war. Then the chief captain came in and took him and commanded him to be bound with two chains, and demanded who he was and what he had done. And some cried one thing, some another, among the multitude. And when he could not know the certainty of the matter, he commanded him to be carried into the castle. And when he came upon the stairs, so it was that he was bound of the soldiers for the violence of the people. For the multitude of the people followed after, crying, Away with him. And as Paul was to be led into the castle, he said unto the chief captain, May I speak unto thee? Who said, Canst thou speak Greek? Art thou not that Egyptian, which before these days made us an uproar, and lead us out into the wilderness 4,000 men that will murder us? But Paul said, I am a man which am a Jew of Tarsus, a city in Cilicia, a city of no mean city, a citizen of no mean city, and I beseech thee, suffer me to speak unto the people. And when he had given him license, Paul stood on the stairs and beckoned with the hand unto the people. And when there was made a great silence, he spoke unto them in the Hebrew tongue, saying, Amen. Full and great and exalted is the word of God and the grace of this holy church. And many are that believe in our Lord Jesus Christ, whom be glory world without end.
Amen. Son, who had the word of the living Father. Holy, holy, holy are thou, Holy Spirit, who knowest all things. Exio Tessalina. Mislam and Fesica. Is he, because he was in a womb, is more fragrant than all chosen incense. He whom she bare came and saved us.
Michael,
given mercy and Valentine into Gabriel,
a heavenly gift to the Virgin Mary.
Tabernacle for the habitation of his beloved Son.
The
tabernacle of testimony according to the word of God, and the air and the place in the midst thereof.
May the chosen incense to go out.
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord among the thousands, honored among the tens of thousands. Thou art the incense of our Savior, for thou didst come and saved us. Have mercy upon us. Mary, have mercy upon us, Lord. Holy God, holy mighty, holy living immortal, who was baptized in Jordan and crucified on the tree of the cross,
have mercy upon us, Lord. Holy God, holy mighty, holy living immortal,
who did rise from the dead on the third day, ascended into heaven in glory, sat at the right hand of his Father, and will come again in glory to judge the quick and the dead. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Glory be to the Father, glory be to the Son, glory be to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and world without end. Amen and amen. So be it, so be it. O Holy Trinity, living God.
Page 170, a big liturgy, and 71 in the small, morning prayer of the covenant. The grace of Lord be with you.
And with thy Spirit.
Glorify, O God.
It is right, it is just.
We
have lifted them up unto the Lord, our Father who art in heaven, our Father who art in heaven,
our Father who art in heaven,
lead us not, Lord, into temptation. Trinity, pity us, O Holy Trinity, spare us, Holy Trinity, have mercy upon us. The Lord is with thee, that he may forgive us our sins.
Thank you.
Deite dich zum Gott des Selassiam, Salom, der Rede, Maria Mesmin, und der Kidan, Chama, begehrt die Amnan und Zag, and all fathers and brothers and sisters, Eagles, pity them that are sick, for thou, what a life of us all, the hope of us all, the labor of us all, and the raise of us all, and the day lift up thanksgiving unto thy servant.
Make a joyful noise unto the God of Jacob. Take a psalm and bring hither the timbrel, the present harp with the psaltery.
Reading of the Holy Gospel is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 3, beginning from verse 25 to the end. The Gospel according to St. John, chapter 3, beginning from verse 25 to the end. Now there arose a question between some of John's disciples and the Jews about purifying. And they came unto John and said unto him, Rabbi, he that was with thee beyond Jordan, to whom thou bearest witness, behold, the same baptized and all men come to him. John answered and said, a man can receive nothing except be given him from heaven. Ye yourself bear me witness, and I said, I am not the Christ, but that I am sent before him. He that hath the bride is the bridegroom, but the friend of the bridegroom which standeth and heareth him rejoiceth greatly because of the bridegroom's voice. Their joy therefore is fulfilled. He must increase, but I must decrease. He that cometh from above is above all. He that is of the earth is earthly, and speaketh of the earth. He that cometh from heaven is above all. And what he hath seen and heard, that he hath testified. And no man receiveth his testimony. He that hath received his testimony hath sent to his seal that God is true. For he whom God hath sent speaketh the words of God. For God giveth not the Spirit by measure unto him. The Father loveth the Son, and hath given all things into his hand. He that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life. And he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abideth on him.
Amen.
Page 37 in the Make Liturgy and 85 minutes more, stanzas 216. He believed on the Son and everlasting life.
And the Word was with God. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, glory as of the only begotten of the Father, the Word of the living Father, and the life-giving Word. The Word of God rose again, and his flesh was not corrupted.
Page 36, in your big liturgy, and in between the small stanzas, quoted,
Glory be to thee, Lord, O God Almighty, who has made us meet here through the word of thy holy gospel, and greeted and rejoiced in it, that again we ask and beseech that thou shouldest write the word of thy holy gospel in our hearts, and accept our prayers in this thy temple, in the Lord Jesus Christ hath entered, and send thy mercy and thy compassion upon us, upon thy people, to thy only begotten Son, for thine is the glory and power without death.
Amen.
Page 87 in your big liturgy and 38.
Slaman Fesu.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ, because his nature is unsearchable, as we have before declared, he is without beginning and without end, but he is ever living, and he has light which is never extinguished. He can never be approached. He is not two or three, and no addition can be made to him, but he is only one, living forever. Because he is not hidden, they cannot be known, but we know him perfectly through the law and the prophets, that he is almighty and has authority over all creation. One God, Father of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, who was begotten before the creation of the world, the only begotten Son, co-equal with him, creator of all the hosts, the principalities and the dominions, who in the last days was pleased to become man, to all flesh from our Lady Mary, the Holy Virgin, without seed of man, and grew like men, yet without sin or evil, neither was guile found in his mouth. Then he suffered, died in the flesh, rose from the dead on the third day, ascended unto heaven to his Father who sent him, sat down at the right hand of power, sent to us the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, who proceeded from the Father, and saved all the world, and who is co-eternal with the Father and the Son. We say further that all the creatures of God are good, and there is nothing to be rejected, and the Spirit, the life of the body, is pure and holy in all. And we say that marriage is pure, and childbirth is undefiled, because God created Adam and Eve to multiply. We understand further that there is in our body a soul which is immortal and does not perish with the body. Repudiate all the works of heretics and schism and transgression of the law, because they are for us impure. We also believe in the resurrection of the dead, the righteous and the sinners, and in the day of judgment, when everyone will recompense according to his deeds. We also believe that Christ is not in the least degree inferior because of his incarnation, but he is God, the Word who was truly became man, and reconciled mankind to God, being the high priest of the Father. Henceforth, let us be circumcised like the Jews. We know that he who had to fulfill the law and the prophets had already come, to him to whose coming all the people look forward, Jesus Christ, who is descendant from Judah, from the root of Jesse, whose government is upon his shoulder, to him to glory, thanksgiving, greatness, praise, blessing, song, both now and ever, and world without end. Amen.
God is pure, let him receive of your grace, and he is not pure, let him not receive of
your grace. Is there anyone who stands in the world of the free? Allah does speak in truth to stand in evil manner. Let him know who understand that the whole gift of the Lord, Jesus Christus, I bring it upon himself of truth. Instead of a blessing, I will get from God in power of hell. Instead of a mission of sin.
Oh, my Lord, my God, I will come to the Lord.
Glory to God in heaven and earth, peace is good, well to us, man.
God in heaven and earth, peace His goodwill towards men.
O Lord, in Thy goodwill, build the hands of us all, and purify us from all corruption, and from all excess, and from all revenge and envy, and from all wrongdoing, and from the remembrance of every close with them, and make us all need to salute one another with a holy salutation.
God, make us meet to salute one another with a holy salutation.
And to partake in our condemnation of thy holy mortal and to give to Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom the name of the Lord, Holy Spirit, be glory and dominion, both now and ever, and world without end.
Amen.
We are going now to the anaphora of St. Mary, page 74, your big liturgies only.
The anaphora of Our Lady, Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Bishop of the Province of Vesna, composed to the Holy Spirit, may her prayer of blessing and mercy and beloved Son be with our patriarchs, of both the Megorius and Buddha Matthias, and our blessed Archbishop of Matthias, and our clergy and our congregation, world without end.
Amen. Thy Spirit,
give thanks, O God.
It is right, it is just.
Lift up your hands.
We have lifted them up unto the Lord, O God. Abata chinoi besimai imit no smirka des mengestitimta. Fekadi besimai deonichinum memedertium. Yeletin rachin in Sidonazaria. Bedelachin irkavalen. Nya ye bedelunin irkaindem la beitu with a fadanamadagvan. Kete fuat denji mengisi antenatina, hailem meskanam desleali muamil. Imi bitin kedes dingil Mariam hoi bemelaku bikatus Gabriel salam tasalam in leshalem. Basabis dingil lesh, visgashim dingil lesh. Yushana figzi abelina toi salam talan shigabashal. Gesia tush hutilitish anshitabare kishnish. Yamai simnis fel tabarekino sagani temalashoi desiabeli shigziabiel kanchikara nuna katavilejish ke gita chin ke minyanta chin ke Jesus Christus en yokotan leminilin hatiata chin in yasis relin zen desile ale muamin.
My heart is indicted in a good matter, my heart is indicted in a good matter, my heart is indicted in a good matter. And I speak of the Anaphora of Mary, not at length but briefly. And I speak in praise of the Virgin, not in many words, which will be forgotten but in few. I speak of the exaltation of the Virgin, and today I stand this very day in humility and love before the mighty and mystery, and before the stable of the offering. Truly this is the offering with those who spirit at the mind and the taste. It is not like the sacrifice of our fathers which depended upon the blood of sheep and ox and cows. For this fire gave up life to the upright in heart, who fulfilled his will in this consuming fire to the unrighteous who deny his name. Truly it is a fire which a fire of cherubim and seraphim who have a flame of fire cannot touch. Oh, Mary, for this love and exalt thee, and because thou didst bear for us the true food of righteousness and the true drink of life. Oh, our fathers, consecrated by the laying on of hands, who are the successors of the apostles, who have taken you for intercessors towards God, and we have taken for intercessors between us and God during our days, these two. Patriarchs of Ethiopia, Father, both of Mercurius and Buddha Matthias, and our blessed Archbishop Ambatarius. O Holy Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, the light, the world, Christian, the love, the blessing, the blessing, the blessing, and the sin upon us, the dream of the Holy Spirit, and make those who lie, Holy Spirit,
Was renewed. There was the hope of Adam when he was driven
judgment of a paradise, the meekness of Abel was killed to the righteousness, the kindness of said works of Enoch on the half of Noah, to which all was saved from the evil destruction, the blessing and portion of Sam, the sojourning of Abraham, the Savior of Isaac, the lad of Jacob, the comforter of Joseph, the tables of Moses, the bush of Sinai, the bells in the garment of Aaron, the priest, the rod which grew blossom and pure fruits, the stone of testimony of Joshua, the fleas of Gideon, the bottle of ointment and the horn of oil of Samuel, the root of Jesse of which he boasted, the chariots of Amminadab, the half of David, the crown of Solomon, the garden closed, the spring shut up, the golden herb of Elijah, the groves of Elijah, the virgin conception of which Isaiah prophesied, the first giving birth without intercourse of which Daniel also spoke, the mountain of Pharaoh of the Africa, the closed house in the east of Ezekiel, the place in Bethlehem from which the Lord goes forth, the land of Ephrata, of Micah, the tree of life of Solomon, the hill of Naaman's womb, the rejoicing of Zechariah, the clean oil of Malachi. O virgin, thou art the idea and prophecy of the prophets, the babe of the apostles, the mother of the martyrs, the sister of angels, the boast of the young men, and the virgin, and the monks who are watchful day and night in thy gates. O virgin, thou wast not conceived through unclean laws, but in lawful marriage was thou born from Anna and Elohim. O virgin, thou didst not grow in the mud like the Hebrew daughters who stiffened their necks, but thou didst live in the sanctuary in the holiest of purity. O virgin, thou didst not eat earthly bread, but heavenly bread prepared in the heaven of heavens. O virgin, thou didst not drink earthly drink, but heavenly drink poured from the heaven of heavens. O virgin, thou that is not known, cleanliness like a woman that will be before thee and now to come after thee, but thou art adorned with holiness and purity. O virgin, the wicked young man could not entice thee, but the angel of heaven visited thee, as it was said, the priest and the high priest praised thee. O virgin, thou wast not espoused to Joseph for coming together, but in order that he might keep thee in purity, and thus it was fulfilled. When God the Father saw thy purity, he sent to thee his ineffable angel, whose name is Gabriel. And he said unto thee, the Holy Spirit shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. The Word came to thee without being separated from the bosom of his Father. Thou didst conceive him without his being limited, and his name in thy womb without making subtraction from above, or addition beneath. They are born in thy womb, the inestimable, unsearchable fire of the Godhead. It is not just to compare with earthly fire. Fire has measurement and volume, but of the deity it cannot be said that it is like this, so he seems to be like this. The Godhead has no circle like the sun and moon, nor statue like man, but he is mighty and sitting in the highest heaven, which neither the tone of man nor the knowledge of angels can reach. The deity had neither bread nor night, had neither above or beneath, neither left nor right. But he is always full of all things. The deity had no place where he could stretch or contract himself, but he fills every place. The deity had neither firmament above nor foundation beneath, but he himself is a firmament and a foundation. The deity will not stoop or bow down the head to take up that which is under, but all is in his hand as it should to be done. The deity had neither chest nor back by which he can be seen, and through which he can be limited. But he is covered with a flame of fire, and he himself is a flame of fire. The deity is clean, pure, and bright. We believe that the Father sent his Father in nature. We believe that the Son who is sent his Son in his nature. We believe that a life-giving Holy Spirit in his nature. Three names but one God. It is not for the deity as it was for Abraham, who was older than Isaac, or Isaac, who was older than Jacob. But the Father is not older than the Son, neither is the Son older than the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is not younger than the Son, neither is the Son younger. is not for the day, the other one that Abraham will give commands to Isaac. Oh, that Isaac will give orders to Jacob, but the father being father will not give orders to the son. And the son being son is unexalted, and the Holy Spirit is equal. But the divine Father, Son, and Holy Spirit are one God. One kingdom, one authority, and one government. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit think. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit speak. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit like. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit take counsel. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit utter the word. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit complete. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit make. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit unite. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit create well. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit send. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit give authority. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bears witness. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit draw. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit accustom. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit advise. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit purify. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit hallow. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit strength. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit encourage. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit teach. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit grow. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit clothe. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit grant grace. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit sin. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit judge. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit examine. Thus may, without separation, finding believe, but confess the oneness and unity, so that it will not be divided or separated. Let us distinguish so that it will not be confused. We do not say three as we say Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but one is three persons. We do not say one like Adam, the first creature, but three with one nature. Now we hear the Jews and the ignorant, Ishmaelites who be without understanding, say God is one person and one body, they are of a blind heart. Now we see that Jewish pagan, whose idols are many and whose devils are many, but we follow the leaders to the good way as the apostles taught us, saying, the Father is the Son, the Son is the Son, and the Holy Spirit is the Son, but it is one Son of righteousness of all. The Father is fire, the Son is fire, and the Holy Spirit is fire, but it is one fire of life and I is heaven. The Father is the dawn, the Son is the dawn, and the Holy Spirit is the dawn, but it is one east and dawn, carried by the rays of his light, and darkness was destroyed. The Father is the vine, the Son is the vine, and the Holy Spirit is the vine, but it is one vine of life of which all the world tasted. The Father is filled, the Son is filled, and the Holy Spirit is filled, but it is one filled, one mixed. Thus you believe, and thus you confess, and they agree.
We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible. And we believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of the Father, who was with him before the creation of the world. Light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one essence the Father, by whom all things are made, and without him was not anything in heaven or on earth made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, was made man, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and from the Holy Virgin Mary, became man, was crucified for our sakes in the days of Pontius Pilate, suffered, died, was buried, and rose from the dead on the third day, as was ascended into heaven in glory, sat at the right hand of his Father, and will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. There is no end of his reign. And we believe in the Holy Spirit, life-giving God, who proceeded from the Father. We worship and glorify him with the Father and the Son, who spoke by the prophets. And we believe in the one holy universal apostolic church. And we believe in one baptism for the remission of sins. And wait for the resurrection from the dead, and life to come, world without end. Amen.
Let us now return again to speak of the Holy Virgin, speaking of her conception, which is wonderful to all, and saying, O Virgin, when the appointed I will occupy the Godhead, whose veins is fire, whose clothes are fire, whose crosses. Again, when I think of this, my mind like so ascends secretly and draws back to the curtains of the hiding places of the living one. It becomes afraid of the flame of fire and does not reaching one forward of the wind to heaven. When I think of this, my mind lies upon the shoulders of the wind to fly east, west, north, and south, and all ends of the world, to see the nature of the creatures, to measure the depths of the sea, and to know the height of heaven. And traveling thus to every part, it becomes faint and returns again to its former place. Now let us not fully inquire or even think of the greatness and profundity of him who is grand, your kind, willing, and praise. No, not by the tongues of the prophets or of the apostles. He is a mighty one whom none can discern by some kind of device. But he came humble among us, he is the Most High. To whom none can attain, but among us he took upon him the form of his servant. He is a palpable fire, but we saw him and felt him and ate and drank with him. Now let us praise him, saying,
Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Living Immortal, was born from the Holy Virgin Mary. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Living Immortal, was baptized in Jordan and crucified on the tree of the cross. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Living Immortal, who is rise from the dead on the third day, ascended into heaven in glory, sat at the right hand of his Father, will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Glory be to the Father, glory be to the Son, glory be to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and world without end. Amen and amen. So be it, so be it. O Holy Trinity, living God, have mercy upon us.
O Virgin, given the fruit that can be eaten, and the spring of that which can be drunk. O bread that from thee that given life of salvation to those who eat of it in faith. O bread that from thee that is hard and the stone of our man that which can be chewed to those who do not eat of it in faith. O comfort from thee that help of those who drink of it in faith to redeem wisdom and give them life. O comfort from thee that intoxicated those who do not drink of it in faith. And cause them to stumble and fall, and add in sin to them instead of remission of sin. And now let us glorify him, saying, Glory be to thee, glory to thy kingdom, glory with pure incense to offer to thee.
Remember us, Lord, in thy kingdom. Remember us, Lord, Master, in thy kingdom. Remember us, Lord, in thy kingdom, as thou didst remember the thief on the right hand, when thou wast in the tree of the Holy Cross.
Jesus Christ, unto the living God, from whom is from every good gift and every perfect gift, became man, fulfilled all the law of man, yet without sin, and learned the law of the Hebrews. He was baptized by John, then in the wilderness, hungered and thirsted, and did miracles. In the same night in which he gave his soul to death, he showed his disciples many signs, concerning suffering, crucifixion, death, and resurrection, and the third day with his body and soul, with bone and blood, as it was before his disciples were with him, on his right and on his left, and when there was come to them, Judas, whose creation was like the tears added to the beam, and who betrayed him.
Please raise up your heart.
At that time, Jesus Christ took bread in his holy, blessed, and pure, and spotless heart.
We believe that this is he, truly we believe.
Look up to heaven, towards his Father, interceded with his spirit, and committed his disciples to him to keep them from all evil. Blessed while he was blessed, broke while it was holy, and gave to his disciples and said to them, Eat, this bread is my body, which will be given to you as a propitiation for the world.
Amen, amen, amen. We believe and confess. We glorify thee, our Lord and our God, that this is he we truly believe.
And likewise also the cup after supper he pointed and said,
confess, we glorify thee, our Lord and our God. That is to say, we truly believe. Claim thy death, Lord, and thy holy resurrection. We believe in thy ascension and thy second advent. We glorify thee and confess thee. We offer our prayer unto thee and supplicate thee, O our Lord and our God. Of the Holy Spirit upon us.
Why is that?
shall not prevail against Satan the day he again the keys of the kingdom of heaven. But I was bound on earth shall be bound in heaven. What was loosed on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Therefore, my servants and I have faith according to their several things. We have someone sent me out of the mouth of the Holy Spirit and out of the mouth of the also of Isaiah, who will not get this over. Whether they are brought fittingly or unfittingly, keep them, Lord, and defend them, my servants, my fathers, brothers, and sisters, and also those made thy humble and faithful servant, and I shall love them and set them free out of the mouth of the Holy Trinity, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and out of the mouth of me, thy sinful and righteous servant. O pitiful, merciful, and lover, my Lord of all, and ages of ancient of the world, accept the penitence of thy servants and thy handmaids and shine upon the light of everlasting life and forgive them, Lord, all their sins, for thou art the ever loving God. O Lord of God, merciful, slow to anger, gracious in mercy and righteous, forgive me my sins and deliver all thy servants and handmaids. For all transgression of curse, if we have transgressed against the Lord with any more word or any more deed, and also by the mercy, for thou art the ever loving God, Lord of all. O Lord, absolve us and set us free, and absolve all thy people, and absolve me, thy sinful servant. Remember, Lord, the other father of my church, of all of my quarters, of the Matthias, of the blessed ambition of the Italian. O Lord, keep them for us so many acts of faith in righteousness and in peace. Remember, Lord, O Lord, men of Trinidad and the pagan of Ethiopia and the world. Remember, Lord, the patriarchs and bishops, bishops, priests, deacons, and handmaids and singers, virgin and apostles and orphans, men and women, aged and children, and all Christian people that are assembled in this holy church. Strengthen them in the faith of Christ. Remember, Lord, our fathers and brothers and sisters that are asleep and resting in the Orthodox faith, our mothers upon Apollo, upon Agathos, upon Abraham's prayer, our deacons, Lucas, Gilapes, Joseph, our brothers, Michael, Francis, Brandon, Christos, Christian, Harry, Gilapes, Wilson, David, Declaesus, Mary, Tapna, Black, Peter, King, Gabriel, Declan, Selassie, Greenwich, and our sisters. Thy to thee, to Brother Selassie, Absalom, Erythe, Maria, Mestre, Colette, Kira, Chama, Pigerte, Amna, Amna, and lay in his soul in the bosom of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and for all the works of every transgression and grace, and from all wickedness, and from all rebellion, and from all false swearing, and from all anathemas, and from all perversion, from mingling the heretics and Gentiles and their requirements. Grant us, Lord, wisdom and power and reason and understanding and knowledge, that we may depart and free from all works of Satan the tempter. Grant us, Lord, to drive your light and pleasure in all times, and write your name in the book of life and the kingdom of heaven with all saints and martyrs. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, through the David and all the Holy Spirit, the glory and dominion, both now and ever, and world without end.
One is a holy Father, one is a holy Son, one is a holy Spirit. And with thy Spirit, exio Marana Christos, exio Marana Christos. Exio Marana Christo.
Mahara Krishna, 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 Krishna
Hosanna, Christo, Sixio, Marana, Christo, Sixio, Marana, Christo. Exio Maranatha Christo, compassion upon us, O Christ. Lord, have compassion upon us, O Christ. Lord, have compassion upon us, O Christ. Salina Misla Manfesica
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Jesus Christ, is no wise beseemeth thee to come under the roof of my polluted house, for I provoke thee to wrath, and have done evil in thy sight, and through the transgression of thy commandments have polluted my soul and my body, which thou didst create after thy image and thy likeness, and in me dwelleth no good thing. But for the sake of thy contrivance and thy incarnation for my salvation, for the sake of thy precious cross and thy life-giving death, for the sake of thy resurrection on the third day, I pray thee and beseech thee, O my Lord, that thou wouldest purge me from all guilt and curse, and from all sin and defilement. And when I have received thy holy mystery, let it be not unto me for judgment, nor for condemnation, but have compassion upon me, and have mercy upon me, and through it grant me remission of my sin, and life for my soul, O life of the world, through the petition of Our Lady, the Holy Mary of twofold virginity, thy mother, and of John the Baptist, and through the prayer of all the holy angels, and all the martyrs and the righteous who have fought for the good world without end. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Jesus, we have shown from our moral service, our departed brother, he can enjoy our mind and put yourself on air, relax until we start from our air, then meditate.
Done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us all trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us and rescue us
from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Holy Mary, we salute thee with the salutation of the Archangel Gabriel. Thought and body, Mother of the Almighty, Lord, salvation is due to thee. Blessed are thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. Hail, thou that highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Pray for mercy to thy beloved Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to cleanse us from all our sins and all unrighteousness.
The Lord,
Gabriel, salam, ta salam, in the chalet. Sia per cancica la nuna, che tu leggi, che guida a cinque, che Gesù Cristo zen, e per tanto le menilin a tirtaci.
Good morning, Theophilus, priest, deacon. Good morning to our viewers who are watching this graduation today. It has been said that this is the 40th graduation that we have done here since our pandemic situation. But we, as Christians, we also have a pandemic situation. Yes, as the pandemic is being spread all over the world, we are committed to spread the gospel throughout the world also. So we are here to give you this spiritual understanding so that our members, no matter that you are not in the church, you are still in the church because of your body is the house of the living God. So don't mind that you are in your home or on your work and you are watching this program, you are still in church or you are in heaven. So today we would like to proceed in our lesson. We had been. But first I would like to say concerning the Bible. What the Bible is about Mary. The Bible contains the mind of God, the state of man, the way of salvation, and the doom of sinners, and the happiness of believers. The Bible is basic instruction before leaving earth. When you come to church, the most prominent book that you use is the Bible, and our liturgy. This is to help with the service so that you can understand what the church is about. Ephesians 5 tells us that concerning the marriage of the man and the woman, what is the man's position and what is the wife's position? And that Christ is the head of all. The marriage was instituted since in Genesis, where God told Adam that he had to leave his mother and father and cling to his wife or the woman, what they took from him, from Adam. When he said that this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh, she will be called woman. A man flees his mother and brother, cling to her, and the two shall be one flesh. Most weddings, especially the Orthodox Church, brothers and sisters only concern of wearing the crown and wearing the robe, not concerning the vow that they are making. The vow is for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, for sickness or for health. This wedding or this marriage, as it said, is like Christ and the church. This wedding have no divorce. This wedding have no indifferences. That's why it said it's like Christ and the church, because Christ and the church is one. No indifferences, no quarrel, no separation, no anything. So when you choose a woman as your wife, it is until death do us part. So clinging to the woman, what is a marriage really? The marriage is that you have gotten back your rib, because the rib was taken from you. So within the marriage, you have gotten back your rib. So the two have become one. As I said in the beginning, man is both male and female. So the woman, she has gotten the womb. This womb is to produce offspring. So she is called the woman. So you, as a man, you have to treat the woman as yourself. Will you treat yourself? No. The same thing with your companion. They said that you cannot treat her, and then later on, you want to go and hug her up and kiss her. It cannot work. You have to treat her just like yourself. And she also has to pay respect to you as the head and the man of the house. And both of you all together, giving thanks and praise to your Creator for bringing you together to start a family life as being fulfilled in our sacrament, which is matrimony, and fulfilling the commandments of God. The book of Ephesians, the first book of Paul writing, he gave us very clear. For the husband is the head of the wife, and also Christ is the head of the church, and he is the savior of our body. Yes, this is our savior Jesus Christ, who came and took flesh from our lady, the Virgin Mary, to redeem mankind. We have many instances concerning marriage. We have the wedding of Cana of Galilee, and then we have in Revelation telling about the bride and the bridegroom. Even in our liturgy, it is said that, but the church will dismiss thee and shut the door against thee, so that thou wilt have enter, because no stranger will be found in her. When the bridegroom cometh, she shall open the inner door, and the bride feedeth the bridegroom. But the stranger shall not eat, because it is not given to him. Who has seen a bridegroom that at his marriage sacrificed his body and is kept on forever? The Son of God has done a new deed in the world, which no one except for him has done like him since the creation of the world. At his marriage, he had ordained on the table before his guests his holy body and his precious blood as a banquet, so that they may eat thereof, and to him who believes in him may live forever. The meat and the drink is our Lord Jesus Christ at his marriage. Blessed be our God, who has given us his holy body and precious blood for the forgiveness of our sins, that we may live thereby forever. Glory to him, world without end. Yes, brothers and sisters, the church is concerning the marriage ceremony of the bride and the bridegroom. This is our example of a unity, just by the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It has no indifferences, it has no quarrel, it has no separation. They are united forever and forever. So it is with man. God has formed you in his own image and likeness, and he expects you to walk in his commandments and his law and his testimony. When we fell, we followed our Satan, he became our father. But God in his mercy came to revive us, to make us lively people again. So he came, he shed his blood for our salvation, so that we, becoming now children of the heavenly calling, we are members of his household through baptism, through the anointing, through the Holy Communion. Just like the pandemic is taking over our nation, we also, as Christians, we have to obey God's commandments. If you don't do this, you will die also. And then in the pandemic now, they are trying to create a vaccine for your salvation, for you to live. So in scripture, we have his holy body and his precious blood for life. If you don't partake of this, you have no life in you. I say many pandemic in today spread all over the world. The gospel also has to be spread all over the world. We as Christians, as his holy children, we have to understand that, as Paul said, that the gate of hell shall not prevail against his church. So we who walk in his statutes and his commandments and his law and his testimony, we have a good chance of elevating ourselves to be the people that he wants us to be. To be true and to be pure and to get away from the vices of the world. You as Orthodox Christian, you know that you were bought with a price. Christ has came to redeem us and to make us his own people. So the scripture here is for our understanding, especially concerning family life, where it is best for us to be married, not common law, not boyfriend and girlfriend, not shacking up. Every woman is good to live with, so why is she good to be married? Marriage is honorable and the bed is undefiled. Because God gave it out of me to multiply. But you must multiply through the process of matrimony so that you can have blessed children. If you come to our wedding ceremony, you will see the blessing that God has laid upon you or put up in the Holy Bible concerning matrimony, man and wife, or the bride and the bridegroom. So the church is here to sanctify us as people of the world, as created beings who went astray. We don't know our foundation, we don't know our mission, but God in his mercy came and he saved us. Therefore, let us try to submit to the church. The wives have to be subject to their own husband. Husband, love your wife. Just as Christ also loved the church and he gave himself for her, that he might sanctify it and cleanse it with the washing of water for the remission of sin. Yes, brothers and sisters, that is how you have become a family or children of the bride and the bridegroom, through the washing of water, through the anointing, so that we can receive of his holy body and his precious blood as a banquet. This is the portion of the church, the mission of the church, because the church is holy and without blemish. So, husband ought to love your wife as your own body. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourished it and cherished it, just as the Lord his church. For we are members of his body and his flesh. For this reason, a man has to leave his mother and father and join to his wife, and the two shall become one. As it is said, this is a great mystery. What is a mystery? Something unknown, untold. But he is speaking about Christ and the church. So we as a member of this church, it is not an ordinary church. It is the church of God that He established here on earth for our salvation. As it says, this is heaven on earth. We as members of His household, due to following His commandments and His law and His testimony, we are becoming like saints, or the first man before he fell. This is our mission, to reinstate ourselves back to our father Adam before the fall. The church is here to help us in all his sacraments and his mystery, so that we can become all the sons of God. The scripture is for our understanding, the scripture is for our learning. When we speak about the Bible speaks about God. And God said, and God said, and God said. When the word is being said, it is manifested. When we speak about the liturgy, it is about the body and blood of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Because the liturgy is where the service is taking place. The liturgy, the main thing the liturgy, is to transform His body and blood, it's the bread and wine, into the body and blood. That is why in the wedding of Cana of Galilee, when His mother asked, He told her about the wine, He told her what time had to come and get. What did He mean by that? Woman, my time has to come and get. And then she said, whatever you say to do, do it. The wine represents His blood. And His blood was going to be shed on the cross. That is why He said that His time hasn't come and yet for them to partake of His wedding ceremony, of His body and His blood. So, in our wedding, it is always good that two can become one. You yourself have become one with the church, to obey the church, because when you obey the church, you obey Christ at the head. So your mission is to keep His laws and His testimony, and to bring up your family in the way that they should, to obey God's commandments, and to love your neighbor as yourself, and to deal with your humanity, not to backbite, not to envy, not to hate one another. Bring up a child in the way that she or he will go, and will not depart. But the church is here, and everybody comes for a different reason in the church. As St. Jude said, there are some of us kept in unaware. Who will be first over ordained this condemnation? Ungodly men, turning the grace into lasciviousness and denying the very God that brings them into existence. Because sometimes we baptize many people, and then when we hear now, they don't accept the creed. They don't know why you have to kiss the cross. They don't believe in our Lady Mary. So then why you came and baptized in the church? But has it said that many will be called and few will be chosen? So we are here to, in this pandemic situation, to still continue our communion services so that the church can stay alive. Remember, they are still with us because they are still in their home, tuning in to the program, so they are still in the church. We pray the Lord that someday the doors will be open again, and that we will commune with each other as brothers and sisters. But still, it has been said many times that we don't want to come to church. We can stay home and pray to God. Okay, so you get your wish now. Now you're asking ready church to be open up. Are you confused or what? 1 minute they say one thing, and the next minute they say the next thing. The church is closed now. It is there just like the days of Noah, where we were eating and drinking and having a good time, until the doors were closed and the heavens opened and the rain came. And they come knocking, oh God, Lord, Lord, we now believe you. So same thing now, and the church is closed, you all are getting frightened. Because you are seeing yourself not partaking of the body of God, you are seeing yourself not sanctified, you are not seeing yourself not congregating with your brothers and sisters. But everything is for a cause and a purpose. In your home now is for you to gather your family and keep house prayer. Now your husband is not going on a line in the brother making all the same home. So you can have a more togetherness now because of the pandemic. It comes like a tree of good and evil. Because it is doing you a good, because your family now is home and you are together as a family. Okay? So we have to try to see the good in it. And try to better ourselves, try to read our scriptures more, try to understand the word of God, try to understand our family life some more, try to put things in place for our family. If you are not married, let us think about getting married instead of being shackled and instead of being common law. Okay? God called you to be official, you need official things. So we are here in a sense. Today is about the 40th session we have here in Aruka, in our communion service. The Prime Minister has declared that we can have 10 now in the gathering, and maybe gradually, we release more and more and more. So we feel that someday it will open up again. But you have to meet us on your heart. You have to be obedient. Just like Christ in the church, you have to obey the commandments. So you have to obey the law of God. He said to wear your mask, wash your hands, and do so many things. If you don't do it, what will happen to you? You will die. So the same thing with the church. If you don't keep his commandments, you will die also. So brothers and sisters, this pandemic is a lesson for us. It is to help govern ourselves better, to treat our household in a more dignified way, for us also to have the God on the streets, to obey the law of the land. And with obeying the law of the land now, you will get a consciousness to try to obey God more and more. So we are asking you as fellow citizens of heaven, as Christians, walk in the Spirit. Walk circumspectly, not as fools but as wise. We give it the time because the days are evil. And it has to say that this is just a little tip in the bucket and have worse days to come. So if you can't handle these days, what about the better times to come? So you have to try to sanctify yourself more in the word of the Holy Scripture. Try to understand your word and its teaching. Try to tune in to the bride and the bridegroom and understand more and more what the church is about, what the church has to offer to us as members of the church, as citizens of heaven. The church is here to sanctify us. Without the church, what would have been? With no sacrament, no communion, no baptism, no death. So what you gonna mean? There's somebody out there with no direction, with no sense of purpose. But God in His mercy, He came and saved us through the washing of regeneration for the remission of our sin. So, as we go through the scripture, I then have a chance to go through the Revelation, which is the new heaven and the new earth. You yourself can read it and try to get understanding. If you don't have understanding, ask God to help to enlighten you and give you that knowledge and understanding, so that when you read the word, you can understand what the word is trying to say to you. Because this is what the word is about. He said, the word that I speak to you, it is life. So reading the scripture, especially the gospel, this is the word of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ that He has given unto His apostles to share to the world so that they can understand what they are saying and better themselves. We want to thank God for all of us here who are back here in this church, all of you all who are in your home and watching this program. All is not lost. God, in His mercy, He will save us from this pandemic. And He said that no matter you have drink poison water or snake has bitten you, you will not die. Because we, as Christians, we are already there through baptism. The baptism is death, burial, and resurrection. So I want to thank you all who came out here today for this service, and those who are watching at home. Continue to be a child of God and inheritor of the kingdom. All is not lost. Okay? God in His mercy, He will save you from whatever ailment you find. So I want to thank you all. Be good, keep the faith. From this time forth, it will be forevermore. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. One more. Amen. I thank you.
King of peace, Jesus Christ, grant us thy peace and confirm unto us thy peace and forgive us our sins and make us worthy to go out and to come into our homes in peace. Amen. May He bless us at the hands of His servant, the Archbishop. Amen. Amen.
And we have been in the holy body and grant precious blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. May you forgive your sins which you have committed with me or under me. May you forgive of our sins and give you full control. For the sake of his body, the divine body, for the sake of the good and the good of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Son of the Lord, go forward, the Son of the Lord, you have mercy and you have been conscious and what you are in love there.
Amen.
Let
us 12 times.
Let us say 12 times. Lord, have mercy upon us, Christ, O King, your
Marana Christos, Ixio 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 Marana Christos, Bente Mariam Mana 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 Christos. And with thy spirit. Christus behaili meskelu lei Jesus. Christus behaili meskelu treyaka ixio ne akute nesina buraka ixia bie treyaka ixio ne akute. Sina buraka ixia biem. We have found grace and we have received his life. We have found grace and we have received his life. By the power of the cross of Christ, by the power of the cross of Christ, by the power of the cross of Christ, to thee, O Lord, thee we praise and we glorify thee in every way. To thee, O Lord, thee we praise and we glorify thee in every way. And she next is valley Adam. Yeah.
us this morning, your prayer. If you've been a strong, continue to do God's work, and we can give you that strength to hold on to your faith. And we continue as usual. Praise God. On Sunday, as we hear our Father told us, the news that we are increasing. So don't give up. After every dark cloud, there is a silver lining. And you know, weeping may come in the night, but joy cometh in the morning. Always have that faith. One day soon, when we reach here again, we forget all these months we were here. I'm telling you. We forget that this COVID never existed. So keep your faith, be strong, keep your family together, obey the laws, and be safe. God bless you. Thank you.